Well, welcome to the new age of computers, from design to delivery.
Huh?
Everybody's like, what? Every leaves.
Oh, wait.
I really have no idea what's going on with this panel. I was just stuck on as an extra.
Yeah, so what do you think of Albany? You think it's a sleepy town for a state capital, don't you think?
Oh, certainly not.
Well?
I am the governor, you know.
You are the governor?
I'm the governor of New York.
I don't remember voting for you.
I'm the governor of New York. Chicken Pataki.
Chicken Pataki.
Chicken Pataki.
That's quite a dish.
Thank you. Uh-huh. You're cute, too.
There is one interesting aspect to this, is that from an internet standpoint, the furry place to be for the longest time was AltFan Furry. That's where you would get all the latest information on what was doing furry world, who's doing what to whom, what books were coming out, you know, what was the new website or what have you.
Great place to roast your marshmallows.
Great place to roast your marshmallows. All sorts of lovely flame.
If you like this, the smell of singed fur.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I love the smell of napalm in the morning. It's the smell of victory.
Shoot me, champ! I love the smell of bird feathers and gunpowder and cornite!
I'm an elk! It's elk season! I'm a killer fan!
Why'd you shoot me? It's so
the alternate furries panel has just begun.
Okay. So. Now, but.
Good.
There are a lot of people that don't quite go that far, as to be. I have heard people say, "Well, I'm just an animal trapped in a human's body." Okay. I am not a salt lick, madam. So if you stop by
not
later,
until after 8.
If you stop by later, we'll work on it. But
I'm gonna hide
there,
under the
we
table.
Have a wide spectrum of.
Not until after 8.
We have a wide something else here, too.
Okay.
If we please.
Can we finish one statement?
Why are you people all looking at me, though? What am I supposed to do?
Think with me. The cockroach is angry because no one will give him free art, so he tries to go after...
I have to draw this up?
Yes. He goes after Tim Roach. He wants Jim Grote to give him free art that he can then put on a CD and sell to people. Remember, we are not mentioning any names. No names are to be mentioned.
I thought this was supposed to do with Red Shadow. What's it got to do with
Well, let's think about this. He then approaches...
This is supposed to be done at 8 panels, Buckwheat.
That's why these people are going to jump in at any moment. He approaches the guy who happens to be sitting next to Greg Shetland, who is his bodyguard.
Cool.
Then interesting things happen. That's where all of you come in.
The cockroach,
enraged
at the unwillingness
to be given free art
of these chintzy, chiseling artists.
These horrendous, ugly, slovenly, chintzy, chiseling artists.
So-called artists. To give. Cockroach, what is rightfully
yes,
his.
Because he is a member of the buying public, and without him, these artists would be nothing, right? They owe him.
There you go.
Yes.
That's too scary.
Too
accurate.
He appropriates. Without the knowledge of the artist, from the table, a Shetland portfolio.
Whoa, hold it right there. You just said something that cannot happen.
Uh-oh.
You said it's a cockroach fanboy, correct?
Yes.
Cockroach fanboys cannot appropriate.
Ha 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 ha
Remember, we have no sex lives.
The artist is out of panel. He's not there. Watching the table is Red Shepherd.
Oh my god, there go the sails. Where's the sails, Red? Oh, I had to get a vodka and beer. And a case of Jack Daniels.
There at the table is Red with a case of Jack Daniels.
No. He's an alcoholic. I don't want a goddamn hammer drink the profits away. You know.
Excuse me, just a moment.
This is a fantasy. It's not really going to happen. It's not going to actually happen. You're just going to draw it.
You better understand something right now, okay?
Yes. Yes.
We're at a convention.
Yes.
They exist.
Okay, this man is beginning to frighten. But all right. He is there for all the artists.
Remember, you just put on special glasses to see them.
But wait, we do have 8 pounds.
Yes.
We could have a chase scene.
Chase scene. Would there be a chase scene?
While we have Godzilla trashing New York.
Okay. It's been done. Yeah.
It
looks up from the table, its arms filled with little shredded bits of Red Shetland portfolios, and sees the bodyguard.
Red.
Drawing her sword. It squawks in dismay. And it attempts to flee through the crowd.
There is a chase.
She carves her way, a path through the fandom.
Yes, she carves a path through the fandom, chasing this little... That can go on for several panels because we can have distinct...
I like that. Carving way through certain aspects of fandom.
You can carve your way through, say, the masquerade. You carve your way through this idiotic panel where poor Jim Grote has to come up with a story in 8 panels.
We know the final panel.
And it
is. The Omni Hotel is in ruins, surrounding Red, triumphantly holding her sword over this cockroach.
Having fun, sir.
Gamma keeper say, get a life!
You were saying?
She has to bring the hotel.
Yes, the hotel is brought down. The hotel is brought down.
Is she powerful enough?
Oh, you're damn straight she is. The hotel is in ruin. The penultimate panel shows basically the hotel crumbling.
After all, it's going to Philadelphia next year. Why do we get care about it?
Yes! We will be in Philadelphia next year, outside Philadelphia Valley Forge. Any questions? Ask me. I'll be kind.
We have the conclusion.
We have the conclusion.
The conclusion will be a pan back showing the hotel collapsing.
Yes.
Shouts and screams coming from within.
Yes, that's the panel. That's panel 7. The collapse. Yeah. Or maybe the last is Red with the cockroach kind of impaled on the end of her sword.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Do you like that?
Says something.
What?
It works. He said yes. The angry cockroach climbing the table. He reaches the top and finds that Red is there. In his surprise, he knocks over...
8 panels, pal. Remember this.
I'm counting them. You see, I'm counting
them.
This is in
the second panel.
I have a PhD, you silly man. I can do this. Second panel. He sees... He gets to the top, and it is not Mr. Grote. It's Red Shetland glaring at him like this with a big smile on her face. And he says, oops. Yeah, that's the second panel. Yes?
Excuse me.
Yes?
I understand. What's this got to do with cockroaches when I thought it was supposed to be about the dragons?
Yeah, that's right.
That's right.
Across the original artwork.
Yes, spilling this across all the artwork that is spread across the table.
Draw a line, Clem, with missing teeth.
She'll be one of the people getting cloven apart.
Why don't we add it? Why don't we just add the Mormon Tabernacle Choir in there and have Moses party in the Red Sea?
That works! All right.
Hey, black Trans Am. Got a black Trans Am chasing 18-wheeler, too.
Jim, 8 panels. 8 panels.
8 panels.
Great idea, though.
Panel 4, we have the cockroach running for his life. You don't know which way he's
nuclear
running.
Weapons.
Goes one eye is looking this way and the other's looking that way. Behind him, there is a sword going...
And a Martian coming up. Hack, hack, brack, hack, hack.
Just gone through. Panel 7, we have the collapsing hotel falling down around everyone's ears. And panel 8, we have Red grinning as she's holding up the cockroach impaled on the thing. And the cockroach looks very shocked. And again, he's one eye's looking this way, the other's looking that way.
Only the cockroach crawls out of the rubble.
What sort of
that would be fun.
What sort of
that would be fun.
cockroaches you can put.
Clutching a piece of a red chest in the portfolio.
Yes, the escape. Here we have the red
escape. I got a tit.
That's right, that tit. The last panel we have read with that savage, insane grin on her face we all know and love. Holding her sword, kind of standing there panting, the hotel is in ruins, and out from under the rubble over here, the little cockroach is scurrying away, dragging behind it the aforementioned...
Say it, you're a doctor, you're a big boy, you went to school. Come on, you can do it!
You shall make me blush.
Yeah, I will. Come on, you can do it, come on, say it, you can do it, come on!
Next! Well, we have our script. We have a consensus this would probably...
This thing will fly to the moon.
It'll fly to the moon.
Now we have...
We have had it from a great writer.
Okay. Question.
Yes.
Who gets to draw naked?
You do.
Bullshit.
Yes, you
I'll
get
draw
to draw naked.
Somebody gets naked. We'll have Mr. Ben Mudodo. He has a whole staff of willing suckers.
He does, doesn't
we
he?
We can have Mr. Blumrich ink it.
Great. He'll just take a bottle of ink and go...
It's inked!
Oh. See, my really point? See my point? He's not that fast.
What about Scotty Arsenal?
Scooty Arsenal?
Scooty or Daphne?
Sounds like a plan.
They ink.
Sounds like a plan.
I can't do both.
Do you think this will work?
No.
Shall I give it to him now and say, get to work, you?
Friday, biggest day of sales, and you got me up here on the panel with this bullshit? Now, if it was Friday night, that'd be one thing, but not during sales time.
Turn the camera off just a moment. We love you. You may turn it back on now. You did turn it off, didn't you?
I abstained from answering.
You son of a bitch. Remember, next year's con chair gets editorial rights.
That was where you were all that time. Get
yeah,
into that.
My face makeup done. That's where I was.
You gotta go to Club Fur like that.
No, I know. Then I am.
All right.
What did you pay?
It took an hour.
You did. You can edit that out, can't you? Because remember, next year's con chair gets editorial rights over this videotape, and next year's con chair, as some of you may not know, is me. So if you want it to be, if you want it to appear in the videotape, don't piss me off.
Or just get the blooper.
Don't piss off
Happy. Oh, yes. Do not taunt Happy Fun Roach. No, I intend to be. Yes, Kagamushi, that's right. Many people may not know exactly who Kagamushi is. Kagamushi is Furry Muck's, to the best of my knowledge, only insect resident. Kagamushi is a cockroach.
Hey, I had a friend that used to play a starfish.
Well, starfish are sort of low class invertebrates. Cockroaches have class, especially if you live in Chicago. Which, as I said at the time, I was a denizen of that fair swill pit, but
I've never lived there, but I've driven over there.
Yeah, yeah.
No, it was when I first was starting on Furry Muck. I can barely recall what my first character was, but it was kind of, you know, run-of-the-mill sort of thing. And the very first person I met was Luca, Ron Levy, another well-known furry. And I said to him, I know, I'll play a human. And he said, no, don't do that. So I didn't. And I was sitting in my apartment trying to think of something unique. I wanted a unique character. And while I was sitting there, I had this ancient dumb terminal and this monstrous black Asian cockroach came climbing up the side of the monitor. And I was quite grossed out. I mean, this thing was like...
But you were inspired.
Footprints. I wasn't inspired. I was grossed out. So I kind of went, go away. And it just sort of reared up at me. And I said, now that is a ballsy roach. Yeah, so that's when the inspiration came to me. That's when I invented Kagamushi, the samurai cockroach. That was him.
I'm going to read from a work in progress, which is set in the Star Rigger universe, which for all practical purposes got started in the novel Star Rigger's Way. The book has, I've been writing it under the title of The Flying Dutchman, but that probably will not be the final published title. I'm still searching for a title. Another possible title is The Empress Conspiracy, but you'll see in a year or so if I get this thing done in the next few months, which is my hope. It should be published in about a year. And it concerns a ship which is known as the Flying Dutchman of the Stars. That, I'm just going to start in at the beginning, and I hope that the prologue and the first chapter will give you a sense of what it's all about. The prologue is titled Ghost Ship. Light itself seemed to coil about and linger in the corridors of the starship lost in eternity. The passengers and crew moved in great straining ripples as they walked past each other, carrying on the business of living, if living was what you could call it. The passengers continued to breathe and eat and drink and sleep, and to socialize after a fashion as they moved around the ship. The crew carried on with their duties, seeing to the needs of the passengers, repairing machinery, and tending the makeshift hydroponic gardens that supplied the nutritional needs of the 500-plus souls on board. The bridge crew continued their work, the riggers forever searching the skies for a way home, peering into the bewildering mists of the flux and wondering what in the name of creation had gone wrong. Their lives consisted of ennui and bewilderment, interrupted at long intervals by heart-pounding excitement whenever they sighted another ship, followed inevitably by piercing despair when their efforts to make contact ended in failure. It was a strange and terrifying limbo in which the starship floated. Though not cut off entirely from the known universe, they remained isolated by some enigmatic layering of the flux, seemingly doomed never again to reach the normal regions of the flux through which the star riggers could bring themselves home. It was a limbo in which they would perhaps spend not just the rest of their natural lives, but the rest of eternity. And yet, what did eternity mean? Time here didn't work the way it was supposed to, didn't pass in a rational or comprehensible flow. It was as though eternity were somehow wafting through the ship, but unpredictably like drafty air through unseen holes in the walls. That was why Jasper and Maria Jones, married on the ship 2 days after departure, now passed their time in each other's arms, not in perpetual bliss as they had once imagined, but huddled in fear in their cabin, where time, through some twist of fate, seemed to have slowed to an even more glacial rate than elsewhere on the ship. There they found a kind of sorrowful contentment in each other's company as their bodies lay entwined in near stasis, that hope they did not find. Down one level in the lounge, a pair of old men seemed always to be playing the same game of chess they'd been playing for who knew how many years. Had they ever gotten up to eat or sleep? No one could quite remember. The ship's captain, Noel Friedman, was always nearby, moving more speedily than the chess players, and yet without aging, stumping up and down the companionways, muttering to himself like some tormented Ahab. And in his own cabin, Ellis Harrelson, Taylor, found himself staring for the thousandth time at his hand and at the needle and bind thread he was wielding. It seemed to him that his movements stretched out as if they themselves were drawn out on threads. It was like watching his life slowly hardening into amber. He didn't understand it and had long ago given up trying. Whatever his fingers and the rest of his body were doing, he could not fathom why his thoughts and his body seemed to move at differing rates of speed. Even in the midst of his sewing, his thoughts reached out to his sister and her family, to whose home he had been bound, lost now across the twin gulfs of time and space. He no longer held out any hope of returning to them, but he could not stop wondering how much time had passed on the outside and whether anyone he had known off the ship was still alive. With a long, deep sigh, the tailor drew the needle in a slow, glittering slide down the shoulder seam of the coat he was altering. The seam split and then reformed itself half a centimeter to the right. He studied the results for what seemed a very long time, and then, with great deliberation, moved on to the next stitch.
a movie retrospective. It was like a Bugs Bunny Film Festival. It must have been about 15 years ago, down South Street in Philadelphia, which is roughly the equivalent of Greenwich Village. And,
Very roughly.
And I was walking out, the last short on the program was What's Opera Doc?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. And I was it Clampett? I thought it was Chuck Jones. Never mind.
But it is Chuck Jones.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. I was thinking Corny Couture.
Yeah.
Chuck
Jones. Anyhow, I was walking out the door, and I heard somebody beside me in rather, more than a hit of mint, shall we say, said, "Oh my God, Bug was so good in drag." Oh, damn it, he does
run that way.
Yeah, he does look good like that. Yeah, he does. Yeah.
And Fudd falls for it every time.
Well, I chose what Fudd likes.
Fudd's a clog.
Yeah, he doesn't get out much.
So. Like, oh,
what I'm saying,
yeah.
It's the view from below. Right. This morning, or when was it?
Yesterday.
Damn.
Oh,
I slept sometime. Yesterday was the view from above. Has anyone here?
Oh, I'm praying somebody tries to break in here tonight. I always keep a magnum in my trunk. You better ask yourself if you feel about any punk, because I'm trigger happy every day.
And of course, it's all that came with them.
That's an intermission.
Don't encourage him.
Government in the process. Bear that in mind.
Anyway.
Was I yelling in your ear? Oh, sorry.
Anyhow, I represent Whiskers Animal Benevolent League. Our spokescat, Emilio, was supposed to give this speech, but it interfered with his nap schedule, so he's back in the shelter. Whiskers is a small, private, all-volunteer-run animal shelter. We're located in Albany. We are the only no-kill shelter in this area.
It is voice auction only, by the way. No twitching of the eyelids.
Yes.
Whole dollar amounts only.
Whole
dollar amounts. American money, the monotone. You Canadians, none of that.
Do not berate my runner.
This is only $5 and won't stay that long. What is it?
185.
Damn.
Do I hear more than 100? 110.
150.
150.
Don't let him scare you. That's all the money he has. So someone wanted it so much in the art show that they put an art show bid on it. Don't you feel stupid?
$45 going twice.
46.
47.
This is the Inherit the Earth CD-ROM for PC with the cheat codes.
Cheaters never prosper. Wonder has been donated by Cecil, who is also the artist. Does not have a title, but it was made for the Albany Anthropon. It's blended pencils and ink, and it's art.
As you know, in order to facilitate the storytelling, I have started carrying a little crib sheet, a listing of the stories I intend to tell. And last year, on a lark, I auctioned it off rather successfully. Now I'm going to do it again. I have in my hand the actual card that I will use tonight. It contains a list of those stories that I think I shall tell. I will probably not get to all of them. I rarely do. If I do not get to all the stories on here, the person who wins the card will hear the rest privately.
Ooh!
This is an actual picture of it on Kulake's crib sheet. And as I told them last year, someday I'll be famous, and it's true. Last year I was a schmuck, this year I'm guest of honor.
I think I've got any on me somewhere.
Be quiet. $5.
What? $10.
$10.
$25.
$25. $30. $35. Don't break the rhythm now. $35. What?
$40.
This man will pay $40.
$40.
$42. $42 for an invaluable, one-of-a-kind, signed-by-me 3x5 card and the stories that go with it!
A 3x5 card full of words for $42?
$42!
But the story that goes with it is most invaluable.
Yes! $42! To sweeten the pot. What?
$45!
To sweeten the pot a little bit, as I did last year. Okay. Whatever the winning bid is on this, I will match with a donation from out of my pocket to these fair people. Woo! The more you pay now, the less money I'll have to bid against you in the art auction. That man is going to make you pay $45.
$50.
$60. Boy, I hope I got that much. $60. $70.
Okay, no, say hang on a second.
What?
How about if everybody in the room gets together and puts in $5?
I'll talk.
In ink on these magnificent women in it. Boards.
Remember, Bill Gates gets no money for this.
That's correct.
Strange and bizarre circumstance, I found myself in possession of 6 electronic rumble and roar Godzillas. If you want to know how I came suddenly to have 6 of them, You have to buy it. What does it do? You push the little button, Godzilla roars, and then vibrates. Starting bid for the astonishing vibrating Godzilla. I got to go home. What is it, sir?
$5.
$10. $15. $15. What? $20. You cannot buy these in the store anymore because the movie really blew. $20 for the astonishing five-year-old Godzilla. Yeah, I only have five now. $20. $20 going once. $20 going twice.
Did you get that demonstration?
Well, we tried.
I'm not going to.
$20 last time. Sold. $20.
This was donated, and the artist is Ted Shepard. He is not here. Okay, then this is the only Ted Shepard piece of original art you're going to find here.
It is a magnificent thing. What is that? It's a winged unicorn. Yes, I knew that.
Good luck finding this anywhere but here, folks.
It's another Microsoft product from which Bill Gates gets no profit.
Whoa, 45!
Remember these?
Not only are these 45s, they are Alvin and the Chipmunks 45!
Original! These are Russian fairy tales. They are in English. It is a basic history of Russia as told through anthropomorphic. Think of the culture that will be oozing out of your ears reading this.
$50. Sign count. Does someone say $59? No?
Be careful when you say numbers out there.
Thank you. We'll take it seriously.
The picture on the box, it's not in the box, but what is being auctioned is what's on the box.
The stickers.
It is a 27-inch Sharp stereo with RCHX television set, front back, cable ready, etc. It's not in the box right now because we're actually using it in the anime room. But when we are done, it can be yours.
If the price is right.
It has been donated by this year's con chair, Mr. Roger Welber, standing up. Screw it, the minimum bid is $50, okay? I'm not gonna go $5. $50.
$75.
$100. This is a very expensive TV set, guys.
$150.
With a man with a very expensive video camera to go with it. $150 to this guy, I'm on camera now. Hi! Come on, this cannot be. $150.
Going once.
$160, that's better.
Here's where I'm going to be schmuck again.
Yes. The current bid is $160.
$161.
$170 going once. Look at this thing. You can bring this thing.
Okay. Got a thing passing around.
Where?
$5 each. It goes to the con.
Yeah.
Everyone
contribute $5. Okay.
Ken knows this guy.
Yep.
Everyone who wants to contribute $5, get up front. If it beats 170, you lose the turn.
Secret!
It's Barney!
This is the only one in existence. It was the prototype. There are some minor scorch marks around it, which is why it was the only one in existence.
I will do a commission for someone regardless of rating.
That's as much as we can say in Albany. None of it goes to Bill Gates. Yay! He'll be crying into his pillow tonight.
$50.
$80.
$100.
$175.
$175.
$200.
Whoa! Let's do it. Let's beat the price of a TV.
It's cute.
It's not that cute.
Oh, it is. You wouldn't know cute. $75. You take this one, I'll get this
decency price finally got through to him.
No, actually, this is my contribution to the auction.
Anyone ask me?
Yeah, we have to bail it out.
Stainless steel handcuffs. The key, or at least the use of the key to release this poor innocent is up for auction.
We're gonna leave it. We're gonna leave the lords right here.
They serve an evil man.
I know. That's what my job says.
Wait a minute. If we get the key, can we do whatever we want with the key?
You are allowed to release him, but it's that's where you will release him that can be creative.
So that the people in the audience can see her. And this is what he did. As you can tell, it is a gentleman. It's got the muscle, it's got the sword, it's got the attitude, and the news.
There are only three copies of this in existence, each of them hand-drawn originally. This is the last one there's gonna be.
Oh, she's blushing!
Blushing.
75! The higher we go, the redder they get!
Final piece for the auction will be brought around by my lovely assistant, Vanna. I mean, Sam. Kage. Dr. Sam, Dr. Conway. Sorry.
PhD.
Crappy animation. What was that? Goldie Gold or something like that? Or the Millionaire Girl? That was what?
One season.
Goldie Gold. Yeah, that ran one season. Superhero little girl that ran around with a limousine and drew a stunt driver and all that kind of crap. I mean, that was
Richie Rich. Effectively, Richie Rich with breasts.
Yeah, and skinny bikinis.
Really?
Muhammad Ali cartoon. There was another real winner.
Also the Mr. T cartoon.
The Mr. T cartoon. There's another two.
Thank
you, Joe. I completely erased that from my mind. Now I have
Karate Kid cartoon.
Karate Kid cartoon.
Anything from Hanna-Barbera featuring mysteries and teenagers and adults.
Yes, yes.
Anything
from Hanna-Barbera. Well, except for the first season of Scooby-Doo, which was not.
I think just about anything from the 70s.
Yeah.
Just about, I mean, the 70s was just like...
Flash Gordon cartoon, the Godzilla
cartoon. Flash Gordon was great.
I like
had breasts. I mean, we're talking women that were silicone implants, every one of them. And the classic is there's a line, actually from the Flash Gordon movie, where the lion guy was going, Flash, you haven't known what it's like to love a lion woman. Her soft fur, her firm breasts, her warm body. I'm going, oh my God, this is a cartoon!
Yeah,
like
but
My Little Pony, Strawberry Shortcake, Smurfs.
The Adventures of Puppy, let's see, they had a Rubik's Cube cartoon.
Rubik's
Oh, yes.
Any fad. Any fad.
Oh, Hound Puppies.
Hound Nazis.
What we start with?
Thank you.
Foxtrot?
My name is Silver Fox, for those that you don't, those of you that don't know me, and this is the man who's actually running the masquerade, Ron. Most of you probably know him. Autographs will be available at the back door as you leave. A little bit of feedback on that one.
What?
Hey.
I'm always looking for feedback.
Ah. Okay, we apologize for the little bit of a late start. We had some room shuffling to do. And of course, elevator shuffling, for those of you who haven't been in them, it's the best ride since Disneyland.
We got a full program for you tonight, a lot of fine suits and actors. So please, give them your undivided attention. Okay, without further ado, I'd like to present Angar, our first performer, who is going to give you his version of the rules. Rules.
Greetings, hello. Okay, a few versions of the rules here. What's that? Probably getting too close to the mic.
Feedback already.
You can tell he's a professional. That's right.
Yes, we cut corners to bring the savings on to you.
Okay, there'll be no biting, no kicking, no gouging of other contestants. There will be no flash photography while the contest is in session, because that way other performers could trip. If I was the only one up here, then I would win by default. That would be wrong. Quarters as long as you think. Don't walk with it. No handstands unless you think you are not covered by the insurance policy. Okay. Other than that, well, pretty much all set, except for a fact to remember, judges, that this is going to Whiskers, the feline charity, so therefore anyone in a feline fursuit counts as double when it comes to awarding those wonderful and gratuitous prizes at the end of the show.
Of which there aren't any.
There's no prizes? But then why on earth did I get up at midnight last night to go spike the water supply with in there for the rest of the furs?
I'll tell you why.
Surprise.
Because you're mad.
That's right.
You're mad. I'm mad. We're all mad. Three. And now River Dance.
A tide of darkness is upon the land. Remnants of a bygone age, vampires. Like an evil plague, they sweep across continents, corrupting the youth with their lure of power. Mankind is being threatened by this evil specter. Yeah. The only hope for life, love, and freedom is...
Mary Davis. of Mary's Secret Garden. Panda Guy also does this to perform for children's charity that he is a specialist in. Feel free to stop him and ask him about it. Since we couldn't wedge it in through the door, so we present Oswald playing Vinny, the biker mouse from Mars. Vinny is violating our no weapons policy.
Love's going to leave.
It's all fun and games until somebody gets...
Thank you.
one many of you know and love, the lovely, introduction to Sino.
Oh, set up.
Ladies and gentlemen, Wawa.
Oh, yeah.